taking time off. It's nice, and it's often easier said than actually achieved. The growing expectation, though, is to be available around the clock with family commitments, even if you have some spare time, even social media, making it quite difficult to take some much-needed me time. Well, to inspire us to book a vacation and to give us some great tips on how to switch off properly, let's go to my buddy, work performance expert, supreme achievement human, Andrew May, KPMG partner, is with us. Admittedly, fresh from a holiday in Fiji, I would say. G'day, Maisie.
Bulla.
So I've watched rather jealously as you've been on a, I guess we'd call it a work holiday, wouldn't we?
Well, I did 4 days of work, spoke at 2 conferences and worked with KPMG in Fiji and with beautiful Fijian business owners. And then I had 4 days of total relaxation. And that inspired me for our segment today to really look at how do you cultivate free space to think, to reflect, and to really reflect and review upon where you're at?
Well, I'm keen to hear how you did it, because you actually went straight from work mode, albeit at a beautiful location, but then I imagine had to try and get yourself to switch straight off and move straight away into what you knew would be a few days off as well.
Yeah, look, I don't think anyone's going to get the violin track out right now and go, oh, poor Maisie, you know, what a tough job switching from 4 days of work to 4 days holiday. But you've been to Fiji before.
No, I haven't.
I think even when you're working there, it's just a beautiful place, the beautiful Fijian smile and Bulla Bulla. They talk about Bulla Bulla. I think Bulla Bulla means everything. It's like, hello, how are you? But it's the greeting.
It's the French joy. Voila, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But your point, I actually had to make a couple of changes in my behaviour, because even you're there and Fiji time is, you know, they show a clock and all the numbers are down the bottom. And what time does the boat leave? It's Fiji time. The boat leaves when the boat leaves, Ed. But in your introduction, you know, we're so connected to social media and to Facebook, and it's the joke that we go to beautiful places and we spend all this time, you know, Snapchatting, Instagramming, tweeting, linking other people into our beautiful photos, that we don't actually enjoy the time. So here's what I did. I checked into the hotel and I went to the safe in the first hour and I put my mobile phone in the safe.
Oh, that's
and
good.
Closed the safe.
Yeah, yeah.
Why'd I do this? I've actually done this to some of my executive clients over the years, and I did it more as a symbolism to go, like, you know, you teach this stuff, practice it, disconnect. I felt a little bit anxious. I felt lost. Like, gosh, I couldn't listen to Talking Lifestyle on that day. I felt just distraught, mate.
I appreciate you were bereft of inspiration, yes.
I was, but I can listen to your podcast. But then I found after a half day, my shoulders dropped, you know, my body eased, and my mind settled. And it was only 4 days, but I felt like I'd been away for a week or two, because I really did disconnect from technology and just, you know, swam in the ocean, ate beautiful food, slept in, and had a wonderful, wonderful time away.
Well, Maisie, I would add that I've heard that both Instagram and Dropbox were conceived during someone's vacation time. So time off can also help make room for innovative thinking and creative breakthroughs, can't it?
Mate, I didn't know that, but that's a great one to add.
Today's fun fact.
Yeah, but the guy that I often blame for causing a lot of our disconnected connectivity is a guy named Bill Gates, amazing philanthropist, you know, putting billions back in to the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. But Bill Gates, who invented Outlook, he used to go away regularly to the Hamptons. This is documented. And he'd go away for his 3-day sabbatical every month to 6 weeks. And he didn't take a computer. He didn't have anything on Outlook or Excel or PowerPoint or any of the Microsoft tools. He went away to think and to reflect and come up with different ideas to get us hooked to the technology that drives our businesses. Go figure.
Now, look, at some point, and if you're lucky enough to get a little quick escape and you want to check in with family and children, can you just quickly punch in the combo to the safe, get your phone out, make a quick call? You certainly don't want to be on the Fiji Wi-Fi, because it's about 800 times the cost. But okay to do a quick check-in and then immediately remove the apparatus back to the safe?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, I left though. I didn't even lock the safe, but it was the symbolism of getting rid of your phone and checking in at night and on the morning to make sure everything was on track and then burying it. But look, for our listeners today going around this beautiful country, would be great for all of us to go to Fiji, but that may not be practical because of work and maybe finances at the time of year and wherever you are. So let's look at a few things we can do, Ed.
Yeah, great.
Weekly, monthly, quarterly, and annually. Where do you want to start?
Well, let's go short term first, and because you've had essentially a little quick break of 4 days, and I want to get inside your head and how you felt immediately after those 4 days, and then we'll expand it out.
Yeah, look, so every week, try and lock in a few hours in your diary. This is one of the most important meetings of the week. I call this forced isolation. Now, any of the seven habits of highly effective people written by the amazing Stephen Covey, Stephen Covey calls it quadrant two. I don't care what you call it. Do it. Lock in 2 or 3 hours a week in your diary, especially for those people who are working or consulting. And this is not to do email, not to do meetings. It's actually to think and look at better ways of running your business, or it could even be thinking about better ways of connecting with your family and your colleagues. So it's just thinking time, number one. The second one is, give this a crack, technology-free Sundays. I got this off my daughter, Michaela. She said, mate, about 3 months ago, Dad, at Science, we've been learning that people have their best ideas when they're not on technology.
Oh, she's on it. Wow. Oh,
do you think, this is what they're teaching our kids, do you think that we could turn our phones off and our iPads off and the TV off on Sunday? I said, Michaela, that's a great idea. Let's do it. 1 hour later, I'm trying to sneak in and grab my mobile phone. So go technology-free Sunday and connect with your loved ones, physically, not electronically.
We're going to do a segment with her next week. You can have the day off.
You know what?
She's genius.
Young kids, mate, they teach you a lot more than sometimes adults.
All right. Next tip. Awesome.
Monthly, and this is, again, for people who are working or consulting. This is at Google, they call it Google time. Any of the managers, senior managers, are encouraged to have half a day off a month or a full day a month for a lot of them just to think about new products, new ideas. So half a day a month, lock yourself away in a coffee shop, the library, or working from home, and just have some free space to think. As I said earlier, the power of cultivating free space. When was the last time you didn't just clog your diary from sun up to sundown with stuff? And yeah. I don't know about you, mate, but I find when I slow down, when I drop the schedule and just have some time to think, I come up with my best ideas. The things that have been bugging me, suddenly, bang, you get the solutions.
Wow, it's true. You're really going to have to physically and mentally force yourself to try this, aren't you?
Yeah, exactly. And you've got to put it in your diary. So that's monthly.
Yep.
Quarterly, this is a mini break. So either go away to just refresh from work. Now, it can be camping for a weekend. It can be staying. You could get some friends who have holiday houses. That's my point recently.
Yes. You're a good sponge. Yep.
Yeah, or Airbnb. There's so many great options. So go away every quarter for a mini break where you just, you know, refresh, recharge, revitalize. But for the cognitive approach, so again, for people who are working at a really fast pace, always connected, I call this the two-day thinking retreat. I think any manager, any entrepreneur, every quarter needs to get away for 2 days, get off the grid, do what Bill Gates did, take a pad, take a pencil or a biro. Biro sounds old, doesn't it?
Doesn't it?
And just, you know, walk on the beach, swim in the ocean, and then just think. It is the lost art of thinking it. It's crazy that we're telling people, get off the grid and just think. So that's every quarter. And every year,
yep,
annually, lock in a proper two-week holiday. And in Australia, we generally do that, or the Southern Hemisphere, over the Christmas break.
Yeah, okay, great. 2 weeks' time. Now, that's always a mad family sort of busy thing. So you then, I guess, have to physically force yourself to find some of those days within those 2 weeks not to be so busy?
Yeah, look, and you're the same, two young kids. I've got two little gremlins, similar age. And, you know, as parents, we want our kids to do activities, and sometimes you can spend so much time and energy in a holiday, you know, keeping your kids and family entertained that you need a holiday after.
Yes.
Try and have some, whether you have kids or not, just try and have some days where you go slow. And if you do travel, you don't have to go to every church, every steeple, every museum. Sit by the pool. Sometimes stay in bed. Just do whatever you need to get your body and brain just to feel like it's, you know, coming back to baseline again.
It's a refresh. Now, tell us, inside your head, how did you feel after you forced yourself for your 4 days off, admittedly in beautiful Fiji? What was the benefit of that sort of mini break for you?
I think it took me 2 days to get back into the pace. I came back on a Wednesday afternoon, went into meetings. I walked in and everyone looked at me really weirdly, Ed, when I said, bulla bulla. So this is, I'm not joking.
Yeah.
I need some help, buddy. It's a week ago, a bit over a week ago, I got back. The last week I felt refreshed. I felt more productive, much more productive than before I went away. And I've got a bit of a spring in my step. I think periodically taking some mini breaks helps you get through the year and the crazy pace we all live our lives. So, mate, big thumbs up. Doesn't have to be Fiji. Just go somewhere and get away and refresh.
And don't lose your coconuts in the meantime.
You had to get in coconuts, didn't you?
had to. Bulla Bulla, my friend, great tips on how you can harness the power of taking time off. As Maisie said, work performance expert, you might have to force yourself to have some solitary or tech-free time. Just start with little bits, maybe tech-free Sundays, as recommended by his 9-year-old daughter. Wonderful stuff.